Hi and welcome back. Today I have a fun video. It's an unboxing video of all the dies that I got by Sizzix as a Sizzix ambassador. So you will have a chance to take a close-up look on the dies that have been released for Chapter 2 and find out if something is for you. Remember, you will find links to everything down below. First, let's take a look at a couple of dies from their Biggs collection. So the first one is called Succulent, and it actually creates a really realistic succulent. It cuts out four sizes of those clover looking shapes that you stack one on top of the other. Here is a photo of a succulent that I created, and you will find a link to that at the end of this video. Now, this is another die that gives you two leaves, and these are quite big, and remember that these are great to cut out not only from paper but also from other materials such as felt, for example, just because these are big dies. And now let's take a few designs that have been released by Sizzix and Tim Holtz. And first, let's take a look at those tiny little side orders, as they call them. So the first one is the Valentine, the second one is the Springtime with lovely images for spring and Easter, and the third one is the Birthday, which I think is the most versatile. Now I'm going to open it up so you can see how it comes. It does have an embossing folder as well as dies, so you can complete a project with lots of texture. So these are thin lids, as you can see, and I love that they come in a plate so you don't have to fight with tiny little pieces all over the place. And also these side orders are designed to fit inside the Sidekick, but of course they fit your Big Shot and any other die cutting machine. So now let's move on to some more designs by Tim Holtz. These are the stacked baroques. There are actually five different dies that you can use to cut out frames, or you can create shaker windows, so many different ways to use those. And these are the funky florals. These are just adorable. I did use those to create a project that I posted a while ago. There are actually two more styles of these flowers that you can mix and match all together. These are packed with dies. There are actually 17 dies of flowers and leaves inside. And at the end of the video, you will find a link to that project that I created using these. Now, this is another fun die. This is called Pocket Frame, and it gives you all those different tabs and arrows and a star and a heart to embellish your pocket frame. You can create pocket frames to add your little photos inside and add them on your projects. And here is a close-up look on it. You just run it through your die-cutting machine, fold it in half, and then you have a space there to add inside your photo. And I believe it comes with 11 dies in this set. And now let's take a look at some thin-lid dies that have been released. Beautiful designs here. And let's start with this pop-up cactus. This gives you an easy way to add this pop-up inside your card, and it is really easy to use. It gives you not only the pop-up of the cactus but also a tiny little heart, as well as two flowers that you can stack one on top of the other. This is the Amour die. It gives you this beautiful triangle, and the design looks like a lace, really beautiful. It's great to create those flap cards, or gate cards as we call them. Also, if you use V-flap envelopes, you can use it to decorate that flap, or if you make your own envelopes, you can use it as well. The top doesn't cut out anything, which makes this die really versatile. Now, this is a really fun die set. It's called Summertime, and as you can see, it comes with lovely images. There are 17 dies inside, with cherries and flip-flops and hello, as well as a camera, a plant, so many different designs to create beautiful projects. And you can see the size of them at the back. I love that it is packed with images, perfect for the upcoming season. These are the concentric circles. It comes with 8 dies inside. This actually cuts out very thin rings to embellish your projects. You can use them for creating shaker cards, to create window cards, so many different ideas here. This is the Waves die. This is not going to cut out a rectangle around the design, only cut out the design, and you can see how it looks at the back. Now, a great idea to use this die is on your art journals, on your backgrounds for summer-themed cards, and also you can cut it out from acetate and use it as a stencil to apply any types of pastes on top. Great die for mixed media. Here is a very elegant looking die. This is called Royal Swan, and you are going to cut out a swan along with tiny little pieces for the crown, his beak, as well as the leaves and the flowers. It does say that there are four dies, but you can actually cut out way more since they are combined in one plate. With dies like this, it's great to do some paper piecing, so you can cut out all the images from white cardstock and then color all the cutouts with different colors, or run the dies many times through your Big Shot by using different colored cardstock every time. And this is a die that is so versatile, I absolutely love it. This is called Built a Landscape. If you like creating little scenes on top of your cards or of your other projects, then this is going to give you the hilltops, the trees, as well as the clouds. And you can see at the back that there is a lovely stitching around, great details, and I think that this is a die that if you get it, you will use it again and again. Now, I love anything nautical, so I'm really biased. I have to say that I absolutely adore these designs. These are called Ship in a Bottle, and they come with 7 different designs inside. I absolutely love this bottle with the boat inside. I think these are all great for creating your summer projects, especially if you want to create any party invitations for little kids. These are all amazing images for that. Now, this is a great stash builder. If you don't have any dies that cut out tags, then this is a great set for you. It comes with 9 different dies with different designs, as you can see, with scallops, with bigger and smaller dies. And I love that they have beautiful designs. For example, 2 of those have a lovely stitching all around them. This is one of those basic sets that you need to have in your stash, that you will find yourself reaching for it again and again. And now, how stunning is this die? This is called Tropical Bird, and I think it is just amazing. It's actually only one die, so you run it through your Big Shot one time out of white cardstock, for example, and then you color in all the different parts, or you can cut it out from different cardstocks, different colors, and just paper piece everything one on top of the other. I am planning to make a video using this die. And also leave me a comment on which of those dies you want to see in action. Something new from Sizzix is that they came up with new alcohol markers. So these are permanent alcohol markers. They come in a set of 12 different colors. There isn't a big range of colors here, so I don't know if you can easily blend them, but there are actually 2 shades from each color, so they are blendable probably. I haven't used them, so I don't know. This is the first time I'm opening them with you, so this is just the first look. If you want a review on these markers, let me know and I will make sure to make a video later this month. Now, if you don't have any alcohol markers and you want to just color basic cutouts that you want to cut out just with white cardstock, then these are great for that. And you can see that they have 2 nibs. Everything is marked on both the caps, both the color and the number. There isn't a number on the barrel, but they are nice and rectangle in shape, so you know that they are not going to roll on your surface, and also they are marked with a thin band on one side, so you know which nib is which. As you can see, they come with a fine tip and a chisel tip, and I'm going to try them out here so you can see how they write. Beautiful color, this one. And the chisel tip, which is thicker, of course. Now, there are 2 shades of blue in this set, and since I'm playing with them, let's see if they blend together. They are a few shades apart, but if you work it out on a good paper that is alcohol friendly, you can get pretty good results. Of course, keep in mind that alcohol markers are not just for blending. You can just use them to color beautifully a piece of paper without having any brush strokes. So these are great for that. Now, along with the markers that have come up with many other products that are really essential, such as this stencil film, there are 10 of them inside, and you can use them with your dies to create your own stencils and masks. And as you can see, they are semi-transparent. And if you go on their website, you will see that they even have shrink plastic, they have iron-on, they even have a glue gun by Sizzix. But the most exciting for me from the new Essentials line are the felt. So these are packs of felt in those beautiful rainbow colors, and there are 10 colors in each of the packs. It says at the back that it is 100% soft acrylic, and of course you can use those with your Bix dies to create beautiful projects. After all, Bix dies cut out felt and fabric and leather and so many more materials, but I'm going to put it to the test now and I'm going to try it out with one of my thin lids dies. I have cut out a small piece from that felt and I'm running it with a thin lid circle die. And you will see that everything is going to cut out perfectly fine, which is perfect just because I have so many thin lids but not as many bigs. Sizzix has also released this pack of cardstock. There are 80 different cardstocks inside and 20 different colors. Actually there are 4 from each color, and they actually match perfectly with their felt colors, so everything coordinates beautifully. This is a great basic pack to have on hand to cut out all your images, and I'm going to take out one of those papers so you can see that it's not completely smooth, it has that beautiful texture on top of it. I will try to catch the light for you and hopefully you can see what I mean. In any case, it's a great quality of cardstock, probably about 80 pounds, and actually the green cardstock that I used to create my little succulent was from this pack. Here is a lovely embossing folder. This one is going to add texture on your projects. It is called Tropical Leaf, and I think it would go perfectly with this tropical bird on a project. And now let's move on to the last thing for today. This is a tool that Sizzix has released. This is called Multi-Tool Starter Kit, and I'm going to take out of the packaging everything here. So you can see that it comes with a handle and 3 more little gadgets, which I'm going to explain what everything does. So at the top and at the bottom of the handle, there are little holes where you can put inside and lock the little tools. This tool that I'm using now is called Distressor Blade, and what that does is to distress your edges from your papers. And if you take a close-up look, you will see that there are actually 4 different blades here, so you can use it again and again. Now this little white thing is just a closing cup that you can put on one end of your tool when you are using it. And now I'm going to take out the distressor blade and I'm going to put inside the craft knife. You lock it down and you can use it. I like the handle, it is very easy to use and you can hold it nicely. I like that it has a silicone feeling to it so it doesn't slip on you. And if you like, you can actually have both tools together, but I would definitely recommend to always keep the cap on when you are using the knife on one end. So now I have the feeling that they will come up with even more tools that will fit on this handle, just because this is called Starter Kit, so I got a hint there. Anyway, I think this is a lovely tool and I can't wait to see what other little gadgets they will come up with. I hope this close-up look video was helpful for you to decide if you want to grab something, and here are 2 videos on projects that I made using products from this release by Sizzix. Thank you all for watching and I'll see you next time.